So if your car battery only starts your car for 1 or 2 days after it's been fully charged, let me show you how to do a load test with a multimeter. Okay, so on my multimeter, I'm going to set the selector to DC voltage, and I'm going to select 20 voltage in this case because the car battery is 12 volts, which is less than 20. And I'm going to then take a measurement of the voltage like so. And you'll see that if I connect the positive to the positive terminal and the black one, which is negative, to the negative terminal, the voltage of my battery currently is about 13 point, if it's a good connection, I'll just put this one back on there. It's about 13.4 volts, which is good because on a car battery, anything above 12.75 volts is more than 90% charge. So with 13 volts, that is more than sufficiently. It's fully charged. I did just drive the car, so the battery is fairly good while charged. Now, when you connect to these to the batteries, you've got to make sure that the battery terminals are nice and properly cleaned so they can make a good contact with the battery terminals. If you would like me to show you how to clean battery terminals, let me know in the comments below, and I'll show you that as well. And then what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take some clamps. This is basically just a cigarette lighter socket with two clamps on it. Now, the purpose of this is just to hold these multimeter probes tightly secured to the battery so that when I start the vehicle, they won't come off and they won't disconnect. So let me just connect these two quickly, that one from the other side. And they are now nicely connected. You'll see that the battery still shows 13.4 volts, so it's still fully charged. Now, the reason for me connecting these to the battery like this, and I want to start the car, is I want to see what the minimum voltage will be when I crank the car, when the car starts. Because if the battery goes lower than 9.5 volts, then the battery would be bad, even if it shows fully charged at this stage. Because between the fuel pump and the injection system and all the other electrical components, including the starter motor, the car needs at least 9.5 volts to function and to make everything work. So if it's below 9.5 volts, the car probably wouldn't start anyway, even if it turns over. So quickly, let me quickly go and I'll crank the car and we'll see what the voltages are. Right, so after that, now that it has started, you'll see it's more or less 13.4 volts again. It's been standing for a couple of seconds now. Now, you would have seen that when I switched the ignition on, that the voltage went from about 13.8 volts, or more or less, to 12.8 volts. That's just the electrical system and all the lights and the fuel ignition system switching on. And when I cranked the engine, when it was turning over, it went down to 11.3 volts. So it was well above 9.5 volts still. So it was enough to turn over the car, to crank it easily, and to start it without being underpowered, if you want to call it that. And after the car was already starting, it was running, you would see it went back up to about 13.1 volts, more or less, because the alternator was obviously charging the battery again. So thereby, we know that the battery is still good, it's in good condition. So you can do this repetitively a couple of times. If you're able to start the car 2 or 3 times and you still get good voltages, that means your battery is still in good state. If it goes below 9.5 volts, then you would definitely have a bad or damaged battery and you probably would need to replace it. Now, if your voltages and everything of your battery is very good, and it doesn't go below 9.5 volt, but your battery still goes down after a couple of days, you most probably do have some parasitic draw in your car's electrical system. And if you would like me to show you how to test for parasitic draw, please also let me know in the comments below and I'll make a video for the on that one as well. So if you did find this video helpful, be sure to like it and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. Until next time, thank you very much, guys.